Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala hama ba'd. Today we're entering, as we know, the last 10 nights of Ramadan from tomorrow. So I wanted to remind myself and all of you of the importance of one of the primary pillars of this religion. And it is something we remind ourselves in every Ramadan, and that is the pillar of zakat, the pillar of zakah. And very briefly, zakah is, of course, linguistically, it means two things. Number one, to purify, and number two, to grow. So when Allah Azza wa Jal commands us to give zakah, He wants us to do two things with our money. Number one, to purify our wealth, so the rest of the money will then become pure for us. And number two, to grow the remaining quantity. So when we give zakah, we will actually grow the amount of wealth that we have. And we all know that it is a haqq that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated upon us. We all know that the Qur'an has commanded us to give zakah in more than 70 verses, that salah and zakah are frequently paired together in the Qur'an. There are at least 36 verses where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the believers are those who الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. Salah and zakah are paired together. In our brief khatirah today, I want to go over 9 specific blessings of giving zakat and 3 dangers or destructions for not giving zakah. Number one of the blessings, and all of these are directly from the Quran and Sunnah, specifically from the Quran and Sunnah. Number one, zakat increases our wealth. Allah says in the Quran, يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِ الصَّدَقَاتِ. Allah destroys the wealth that comes from riba. And Allah yurbi, tarbiyah. And Allah makes the sadaqat cause the rest of the money to grow. So blessing number one, when you give, your money will actually increase and not decrease according to the Quran and Sunnah. Number two, giving zakah causes our worldly distresses to become minimal. Allah protects us from the griefs of this world. Allah says in the Quran, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَاهِرُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا وَصَلِّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ صَلَاتَكَ سَكَنٌ لَهُمْ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, take from their money, take from their money their zakat, and also make dua for them, for in that there is a purification, and in that there is a comfort for them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls a calmness and a purity, it will come when we give zakat to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know as well, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that giving zakat averts calamities. He said when one of us is sick, we should give sadaqah to cure the sickness. So zakat is actually a medication. Our scholars say that the tibb al-nabawi, the prophetic medicine, when one of us falls sick, we give zakat as a purification and a cleansing and a medicine for our disease. Number three, the zakat is a proof of one's iman. The zakat is a proof of one's iman. In a hadith in Sahih Muslim, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Was-sadaqatu burhan," and giving charity is an evidence. It is a burhan. Burhan is an evidence that is beyond doubt, and sadaqah is a burhan of your iman. So when we give sadaqah, it is the strongest evidence that we have iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because none of us gives money except that we want something back. And when we give to Allah, we have to have yaqeen that Allah is going to give us back. And that is why when we give zakat, we are demonstrating our yaqeen. We know Allah is going to pay us back more. And that is a demonstration of our faith. Number four, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, that of the characteristics of the people going to Jannatul Firdaus, the highest level, Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The believers are successful. And then the verse goes on, and one of the main characteristics, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاتِ فَاعِلُونَ. And they are those who are fa'ilun. Here means they're eager and they're continuous in giving their zakah. So to be continuous and eager to give zakah is the necessary characteristic to enter Jannah. Of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions of zakah, He specifically says in the Quran that Allah accepts our zakat and sadaqah before any poor person. When we give sadaqah, do not think that we are putting it in the hand of the faqir. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting it directly from us. Allah says in the Quran, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَأْخُذُ الصَّدَقَاتِ. Don't they know that Allah forgives the tawbah and Allah accepts their sadaqat? وَيَأْخُذُ الصَّدَقَاتِ. So when we give sadaqah, do not think you are doing the person in front of you a favor. Rather, make dua to Allah that Allah accepts that sadaqah. When you give your charity, that charity is going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a proof of your iman. And as Ibn al-Qayyim said, if the mu'min really understood, he would realize he is more in need of the beggar than the beggar is in of him. He is more in need of the beggar. He is more in need to find somebody to give and to be motivated to give than the beggar is of his money. Because the mu'min needs Allah's forgiveness and the beggar only needs money. You are more in need of Allah's forgiveness than the beggar is of money. So if you understood this, you're not doing any favors when you give your money. This is the best demonstration of your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of the blessings of zakah, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الصَّدَقَةَ تُطْفِئُ غَضَبَ. That charity dissolves and extinguishes the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing extinguishes the wrath of Allah like giving sadaqah and charity. And we, all of us, have our sins and we have to account for those sins. So what greater way to dissolve those sins than by giving charity? Of the blessings of charity is that it protects us from Jahannam. It protects us from the azab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَالَهُ يَتَزَكَّى. That the righteous are going to be saved from Jahannam. Who are they? The one who gives their money. And he gives it, ibtigha'a wajhillah. He gives it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gives it, yatazakka, to purify his wealth. And so, of the blessings of sadaqah, it protects us from Jahannam. And of the blessings of sadaqah is that it allows us to enter into Allah's rahmah. Allah says in the Quran, wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. My rahmah encompasses everything. فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. I will give it to those, I will give my rahmah to those who have taqwa and those who give their zakah. So Allah links his rahmah to those who give their zakah. And there are many other blessings as well. Of the dangers of not giving zakah, brothers and sisters, number one is the fear of hypocrisy. Those who don't give zakah, they have an element of being a munafiq, pretending to be Muslim and you are not really a Muslim. Allah says in the Quran, Surah Tawbah, وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهَ لَإِنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُنَّ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَاسْتَغْنَوْا وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. That Allah says there are those people, they promised Allah, if you give me, O Allah, I will show you how generous I am. If you give me, I will do this and I will do that. But when Allah gave them, they were stingy and miserly. And they turned their backs away from charity and they walked away. فَأَعْقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ يَلْقَوْنَهُ. So because of that arrogance, Allah wrote nifaq in their hearts until the day they will meet Allah. Not giving zakah is a sign of the essence of being a munafiq. How can you pretend to believe in Allah and you will not give the haqq of Allah, which is such a small percentage? Of the dangers of not giving zakah is a destruction of one's entire wealth. Read in the Quran, Surah Al-Qalam, also called Surah An-Nun, Surah Noon, the beginning of Surah Noon, Noon Al-Qalam Masturun. There it mentions the story of people who had a garden. It's a long story. I gave a khutbah about this a number of years ago. And those people, they were brothers. They inherited the garden from their father, who was generous. Their father was a generous man. The father died and the brothers said, okay, let's keep this garden a secret. Let's go and lock all the doors. And there was a day the father was generous. All the fuqara would come. And the brother said, we're going to go and we're going to get rid of the wealth and spend it on ourselves. And we're not going to give a single penny to the fuqara. And so they left in the middle of the night so that they arrived before the fuqara. And what happened, Allah says in the Quran, that as they slept, a fire came and destroyed the entire garden. So much so when they arrived, they thought they had arrived at the wrong destination. And they repented to Allah and they realized, we made a mistake. Our stinginess cost us the garden. And they repented to Allah. So the point being, If you don't give to Allah, there is a danger that Allah will take everything away, because the purpose of our wealth is to give to others, it's not to hoard. The purpose of our wealth is to be a source of barakah to other people. And the final point we'll mention, time is limited, of course, there's so many points. The final point we'll mention, very scary point, especially in light of what's happening around the world, is that our Prophet ﷺ said, five things, if you do them, I promise you five others. Five things you do them, I promise you five others. And one of them, that never has a nation stopped giving zakah, except that Allah has stopped the rain coming down and sent droughts upon them. Food will become scarce for the land. وَلَوْلَ الْبَهَائِمِ Were it not for the animals, it would not rain at all in that area or land. So in fact, not giving zakah brings about a general adab. And this is something that we see with all of the changes taking place. And of course, brothers and sisters, really, I don't need to stress upon you. Wallahi, how can any one of us be stingy when it comes to zakah? And Allah is asking us 2.5% of what we have saved. And Uncle Sam asks us 30% of what we earn. Look at the difference. Allah is asking us 2.5 of what we have saved. The savings of our year, not of our income. After we pay the bills, after we pay the school, after all of that, what do you have left for a year? 2.5% is for, and that's the minimum. Of course, we should give more. And we know how much taxes are, and we know we have to pay them. SubhanAllah, brothers and sisters, how can anybody not afford to pay the zakah? And of course, the final point, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq in his khilafah, when those new Muslims who weren't really Muslim at the time, they said, you know what, we don't mind this religion, we'll believe in your God, we'll pray the salah, but don't take our money. We're not going to give zakah. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, these people are not Muslim. They're not Muslim. And he said, وَاللَّهِ لَأُقَاتِلَنَّ مَنْ فَرَّقَ بَيْنَ الصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ I will consider the one who doesn't pray the same as the one who doesn't give zakah. If he prays and he doesn't give zakah, he's not a Muslim in my eyes. And he fought them as if they were murtad. One of the categories of murtad in the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, they're called mani'i al-zakah. They said they're Muslim, but they refuse to give zakah. And the scholars and the sahaba agreed that these people are not Muslim. SubhanAllah, brothers and sisters, let's give our zakah. And I'm not going to give a fiqh talk of zakah this year, but I'm here every single day. So if you have any questions, you can approach me, insha'Allah ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Two announcements that are not meant to be going on public. Number one, our logistics for the qiyam. For the qiyam, tonight will be the first odd night. The khutbah, inshallah, will be about the blessings of the odd night. So tomorrow night will be the first odd night. So tomorrow night, we will begin our qiyam as well. 2:15 a.m. to 3:30 a.m. 2:15 to 3:30 every single day, every single night, and the suhoor will be over here. Our khatam Qur'an will be on Friday night, the 29th night of the Taraweeh prayer. So on Friday night, 29th night, there will be the Taraweeh prayer. And on a personal note, many of you are asking about my father. Make dua, he's still in the hospital, but inshallah, he's not in critical condition. So he's still not released. But inshallah, I hope in a few days he'll be released. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.